Conditional formatting allows you to format the contents or the format a cell differently depending on what's in that cell or in other cells. The best way to show you is with some examples. So here, for example, we've got some revenue growth, and these are the growths in different branches. We want to have anything that's, let's say, less than 10% turn red. Let's say above 30% it must turn green, and anything between must be yellow. So we could do it manually, but what that means is next month we're going to have to manually redo it again. We continually need to check. So what we should be able to do is I can highlight those cells, I go to the Home tab, Conditional Format. Now the actual tool is down here, New Rule and Manage Rules, but you'll see there's some wizards which help us do certain standard things. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to say if it's greater than 30%, we want it to turn green. So I'm going to click on greater than. You'll see Excel guesses 15%. We're going to just change that and make it 30%. So it's going to say that any cell that is greater than 30% is going to be formatted, and Excel has guessed light red full with dark red text. You can see there's some standard colorings, but we're going to go to the custom format. And this is your normal format cells. So you'll see you can change the number categories. You can play with some font items. You can mess around with the border. And the most common one is we can fill it with a color. So I'm going to say turn it green, please. So when I say OK, you'll see it automatically turns it green. And if I say OK, that one is automatically turned green. If I want to add another one on, so now we want between, let's say 10 and 30% must be yellow. Again, the cells are highlighted. I go back to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, and you'll see one of the options is between. So I'm going to say between. Excel guesses again. So I'm going to say between 10% and 30%. Again, it's going to use light red full with dark red text. I could use yellow. That's what it looks like. Well, I'm going to go to custom and choose that yellow there. Say OK. So we've now added two conditional formats on. I'm going to add a third one. I'm going to say highlight cell rules. You'll see the option here is less than. I'm going to say less than 10%. And this one, I'm going to make it red. So when I say OK, what we've now got is three conditional formats on these cells. The benefit of conditional formatting is if it turns out that that's not 21%, but actually 2.1%, when I click Enter, you'll see it turns red because that is below 10% and it knows it must turn red in that case. Just before we continue and show you some of the other things you can do, I just want to show you what's actually happening here. So I'm going to highlight those cells again, go to Home, Conditional Format, and at the bottom here you'll see it says Manage Rules. So when I click on it, it will show you all the conditional formats you have either on the current selection, what we've selected, or there's a couple of other options here. For each of these, you can click on them. You'll see you can delete, you can edit, or you can create a new rule. You can move them up or down. So if I go here and I say edit rule, you'll see this pops up, quite similar, maybe not as user-friendly as the wizard, but it should be clear to you. So you can see it says cell value, less than, and all of these things you can change, and you can change the number. Just going back